the kitchen of our smart home takeover, and today we're cooking up a new recipe for the lighting. We're going to take these down lights in the kitchen and turn them from this rather average lighting into this. I'm going to show you how super easy that is using the Ansell Octo range and the WIZ protocol. So let's have a look at the Ansell Octo range here, Gary, and we're starting with our favourite, the LED strip.
It's RGB and colour tunable white.
That's the master version there with the driver. You can also get an extension kit. Next we've got the lamps. We're going to use the GU10 colour tunable version. There is an RGB and colour tunable version that you can get as well.
I'm going to get my hands on that remote control as well.
Oh, good, and there's an occupancy sensor that we're going to put in this system. And don't forget, you can also get this system in the Ansell Prism range in a colour tunable white version. Check out that video.
So we're going to replace our GU10s with these smart ones from Ansell. So it's just a simple case of getting them obviously out of the box, pop out the old ones, just a twist in this case, in order to get it out. I'm sure your eyes are focusing on that ceiling as well. This is a new build, that's nothing to do with us. So we're just going to put this into the actual lens itself and take out the original lamp, and then that will be the smart Ansell lamp fitted. So nice and straightforward. Just pop it in, and all that's required then is just screw it back into position before we have a look at the LED strip.
Wow, that is easy.
Yeah. So the LED strip itself, we're going to have to obviously remove the original lights. They're not very good at all, are they?
No, so that, yeah, not much light came out of them, and a bit of a strange colour, so they had to go. We're going to fit them underneath the cabinet and on top as well.
So just get these out of the way and then we fit the strip. So we changed the atmosphere in this kitchen with the most minimal amount of input from us. We changed a few lamps to smart ones and we added a bit of LED strip.
Yeah, we love LED strip. And obviously when we start mentioning smarts, that's when, yes, some few electricians sort of, switch off from the process. But the great thing about this Octo system with the WIZ protocol is that it works out of the box and you get two scenes without doing any commissioning whatsoever.
So I've installed the Octo lamps here in the hallway, and just by simply operating the switch, I can go between cool white and warm white. Okay, no setting up, no commissioning, just operate that switch. Exactly the same in the kitchen where I fitted the GU10 lamps. Just operate the switch and change between cool and warm white.
Yeah, so that's a great system if you want to just get your install done, get the system up and working, possibly the client comes along later on and can decide what scenes and colours they want. It's the same on the strip. And the great news is, obviously, these startup scenes you can program once we get to the app to select those colours that you get when you flick between the switch.
I absolutely love that. Operate the switch twice and you can change the lamps or the LED strip from cool white to warm white.
Well, that's fantastic, Gary. But in this house, obviously, these down lights are controlled by the switch near the door. The under cabinet lights are controlled by the switch under the cabinet. If I want to bring them together, I can use the app to do that. And now let's see how easy that is to set up. So let's add the lamps that we've installed to our app. So we're going to have to put the lamps into a discovery mode. So choose the lamps, make sure your Bluetooth is on. Again, this is the app guiding us through the process. And then we're also going to have to connect to the Wi-Fi network. It's important to you connect to 2.4 gigahertz. That's what we see with a lot of these smart systems. So they need the range, not the data output, sort of that. So dead easy to put them into pairing mode. It's a case of switching the lamps off and on.
And this is actually turning off four, isn't it? You've got two on the left-hand side and two on the right-hand side that we can't see.
So now the app's scanning for those lamps. We're looking for four sets of LED strip. They are coming in now. Now we've found those, we can finish this part of the process. And let's just identify them with the app to see which ones we've got there.
So that's the upper one being changed its colour temperature.
Yeah, so we've got four here. You can only see two on the camera at the moment.
That's the bottom one.
So the next phase, really, you want to give them a sensible name so we can remember where they are when it comes to doing the commissioning and setup and any future alterations.
Okay, so your name in, is this the bottom set you're naming on the left-hand side now?
Yeah, so under cabinet, I think we'll call it that. It's a sensible way that we can find it, and we'll call it left-hand side.
Okay, so you're going to name and identify all four sets now, are you?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Speeded it up now. So, yeah, so you're going to be named all four, yes? Right, okay. What's going to be next then? What are you going to look at in the app?
Now, obviously, we've identified and given them names. We want to group them together under a scene.
Right, okay.
So, obviously, we don't want to alter each set of lead tape individually. We want to do them as a group. And
right.
That's where the scenes come in. So I'm going to set up a scene. So, again, you set the colours you want individually. That's the first part thing to do, but you only obviously have to do this once you've set the scene up. So I'm going to select a colour.
Oh, this will be interesting.
Let's go for blue.
Wow, I like that.
So I'm going to add that as a standard palette so I can cut and paste that to other other sets of the lead strips. I'm going to put that on both upper sections.
Right, okay, so they're both now blue. And you can choose something to add.
Yeah, just slightly alter the colour temperature of the lamps under the bench, obviously, so you might want colour above, but obviously you still want white light underneath when you're going to be working in the kitchen. So that was easy. And then I'm just going to create the scene, again, give it a sensible name. I'll call it blue.
Okay. So we've got blue at the top then, and we've got a warmer, is it a warmer white underneath?
It's still coolish on the skin, but it's, that's our first scene done. Let's repeat. Now, obviously, you can pick from some standard dynamic scenes in there. So, obviously, there's a slight flickering of candlelight in that one there. That's already pre-programmed in, so it takes a lot of the work out of you, especially on RGB. That's another great feature.
That is lovely.
I've paired that with a warmer white this time.
Right.
And I'm going to call that our candlelight scene. And then, obviously, step and repeat that through some other scenes again. The red scene.
I like that one as well. So we're going to do about four scenes for us?
Yeah, just let's start with four scenes. We had a warm white in there as well. Now, obviously, we've got those other lamps we put in as well. So let's add them to the control system. So again, let's put them into pairing mode.
They're on a completely different circuit. They're on a completely different switch. You're going to bring the two together now?
Yeah, so again, that's the great thing about scenes. You can obviously be controlling lamps on different circuits under one scene.
And that's just... simply found those, and you're going to be either cool or warm white now with these.
Yes, so you can't have too much colour. It's a kitchen and not a disco. So I'm just going to give them a symbol that obviously reflects what they are. So they're downlights, so let's have a nice downlight symbol in there. So again, it makes that setup a lot easier. We're going to probably name them again, so just find the ones that we're looking for.
So again, we've seen two of the four that are in this area.
Yeah, so just make sure I haven't sort of picked up a lamp that's in a completely different room. But... so again, I'll just give them a sensible, so I'll call them cooking area, just to differentiate them from the dining area in here, which is on a different circuit, but that doesn't necessarily affect our control when it comes to scenes. So before we add some lamps to the scenes we've just created, let's just see how we can set that default mode, that mode 1 and mode 2, when you flick the switch. Again, that's in the app, so I'm going to change it. I'd rather come on as warm white when I first switch a light on from a switch. And then add my second mode as cool white. So again, that's just simply done inside the app. Really easy and quick to do. So now I'm going to add the lights that we've just added into the room. I'm going to add them to a scene. So what I'm going to do now is obviously get the lamps, you know, with this red scene here. I want them as a nice warm white colour to match the under cabinet lighting that we added earlier. So just again, go into the app. Set the warm white. You could also set a different dimmed level if you wanted to in here. Set them there. So then I'm going to, I've set the lamps the way I want them. So now just this update the scene that we set earlier. So again, just scroll through, find the scene, and then refresh it with the current status of the lights. And there we go, I've added them quickly and easily to the scene. So then just repeat that. Really simple. Now, the next problem you're thinking, I don't like just, you know, what scene one, scene two. Here's a way we can actually add a visual image to the app. So I'm just taking a photograph of what the room looks like with that scene and assigning a picture to it.
Well, so when you open up the app, then rather than just seeing blue, you're actually going to see the actual light pattern it creates by clicking on that one. That was gorgeous.
Yeah. Now, this sort of feature, you know, on a high-end control system, you know, a few years ago, these were high-end features, but on this, really easy to set up and can do it all from your phone. This is just shows how powerful this Octo system with the Wiz protocol is.
Yeah, look at that lovely red one as well.
We like the blue early,
yeah. Yeah, well,
now the red's your favourite.
Well, and the blue's my favourite, but I mean, it just looks stunning, doesn't it? So that was fantastically easy once again in order to set up the lighting scenes in this area. But maybe I don't always grab my phone. I can always use the remote control as well.
Well, you can. So let's have a look at how easy it is to add a simple remote control to this system.
Well, I am proper excited about this. A remote control with four scenes. I can brighten it and dim it down as well as turn it on and off from this remote control then, Gordon.
So again, this is very easy to add to the system. Again, all done through the app. So we're going to add a remote, put the remote into pairing mode. It's going to search for it. It doesn't take very long. There we go, there's our remote. It's already assigned to some scenes, but let's change it so they're assigned to some of the scenes that we set up earlier. So I'm going to select the scene itself. So we're in the kitchen.
I'm going to select button number 3, and then I'm going to assign that to our blue scene. So again, just find the scene that we set up. There we go, there's your favourite blue. And that was that done. So let's put button 4 as the red scene that we set up.
So now I've got that on the button, press it for blue, but I've also got control that I can turn all the lights off in that area and dim them that are on 3 different switches in 2 different circuits.
Yeah, so that's, again, saves you altering the fixed wiring to get control from one location.
And this is me going through now the remote control. Yeah, it's great, isn't it? So I've got the 4 scenes, got the ability to dim, as well as obviously brighten and turn it off. So there I am dimming it down, and there we go off. Yeah. There's our lovely red. I'll bring that down as well. If I just dim that down, just see it coming down. Yeah. We'll pull back in a minute. I want to show the sort of the lower end of the kitchen. Look at that.
Now let's not forget as well, we're not covering it in this video, but you could also set it up to work with your voice assistant and obviously get voice control of the lights as well.
Yeah, and simple intervention to make it a wow kitchen. So we've seen how simple it was to add the scenes to the app, then transfer those scenes onto the remote control. Is there any other great features that we can have with this system?
Well, a keen item you might have spotted, small occupancy sensor there as well, which can be obviously used to trigger a scene and switch the light off when somebody leaves the room.
So we're going to add our battery-powered occupancy sensor to the system. So again, just clip in these AA batteries.
Nice to think there's no wiring to it as well, so that's good.
Yeah, again, so this is an ideal option. You know, your phone's flat. You've lost the remote control. You still want to switch all those circuits on, not be messing around with light switches. You can just walk into the room and obviously bring on a scene that you've set, or even there's a special nightlight scene as well for that if you don't want to bring on at full brightness.
Okay, so this is just going to be screwed. I saw you put it on the side of the unit at pointing at the door.
Yeah, so again, yes, that's the best place. Yeah, where you're going to enter the room. Okay, it's a nice little compact sensor, this.
Okay, so base is on, you can angle it then towards, obviously, the doorway. And I take it then it's a simple process of finding it in the app.
Yeah, so again, getting used to this now. Add an accessory. We need to put the PIR into discovery mode. So again, just a little press on the side, flash of the blue LED, and we're ready to be discovered. Name it again, something sensible, so they know where it is and possibly what it's doing. And then you can obviously choose a scene that's triggered and alter the parameters associated with it.
Right, okay, so in we go then. So what are we going to alter first then?
We might want to just trim the time, and then say that action, what happens when someone enters the room or leaves the room.
Okay, so you just bring that down to about 15 minutes, yeah? This Ansell Octo system with Wiz is something that I think is incredibly easy. I watch you do all those bits on the app thinking, I want this in my property, Gordon.
Yeah, now that's something from somebody who is normally shies away from doing anything related to an app. But from my perspective, I've spent a lot of time with lighting control systems over the years. Most of them are designed by engineers for engineers, and I mean, you need to spend loads of time on your laptop. This one is super easy. It's got some really powerful features that we have only touched on the surface of. I mean, there's things in there. You can have plant growth lights. You can have relaxing algorithms. You can have it tuned throughout the day. Yeah, a great system. Easy to install out of the box. Easy electrical installation. And hopefully some more exciting things to come.
What also is fantastic, it's a trusted brand that we see in the lighting industry. This is Ansell. This product works out of the box. The app was easy to install, but as always, we're interested in your comments. Have you fitted the Octo range from Ansell before? What's your feelings? Is there any top tips you want to give us? Is there any little gems within the app that you want to mention in the comments? As always, we're interested in your feedback. If there's other people in there and you can help them, please help them in the comments, and we'll try and answer also as many as we can.